still did some. You probably remember the video with very scantily attired, and some people considered it a bit risque, that video. And it was a song, Blurred Lines, you know, a massive international hit. But, you know, for those of you who are maybe a bit older, you would recall maybe a certain artist by the name of Marvin Gaye. And he had a hit song called Got to Give It Up. And so the eagle-eyed ones, or I would say sharp-eared ones, noticed the similarity between the two songs. And, but of course, Marvin Gaye is already dead. For a number of years, but 70 years I was talking about after the life of an opera, his U.S. employee, when his family could sue, and you know what? They won for copyright, and similarity was strong enough, and they were awarded $7.4 million. Not bad, huh? So that's copyright for you. Now, the World Intellectual Property Organization, where I spent 30 years of my life, is one of the specialized agencies of the United Nations. And it was created in part based on the assumption that there was a significant causal relationship between intellectual property, technology transfer, and development. And that's very important. So that belief that intellectual property is a source for technology transfer and that will lead to development. So of course that's very attractive for developing countries. And you know, the reality is that the countries and the individuals